just wait till the end of the night, man.
No.
All
right.
So volume 20%
or 30%
what you ask
from
the ratio?
From me or from someone?
I'd love that.
Yeah, man, I got a thing. My petty banter. Jeremy, you gotta remind me that I have a. I have a really good clinic story. You can only imagine.
All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to Jazz Record Art Collective. Yeah. All right, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We are proud to present Jon Deitemyer performing Art Pepper's 1961 release, Art Pepper Plus 11. As you notice, there's 11 people on stage. As we do with all of our performances here, always accompanied by a live visual artist. Our visual artist tonight is John Airo. Give it up for John. For those of you at home, he is in the lower left-hand side of your screen. For those of you in the room, he's over your right-hand shoulder. And for everybody watching at home, in the lower right-hand side of your screen, that's the important screen. That is the virtual tip jar. That's how you tip the band. That's how you tip the artist. If you like what you see in here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective. We're doing two sets tonight. Side one, take a break. Side two, and then have some fun. So sit back and relax. Let's start the show. Give it up for Jon Deitemyer. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for being here. It's such a pleasure to play for people in a room again. How about that? Yeah? It's a pleasure to play with these particular musicians, all my friends and musical heroes, for sure, without exaggeration. Everyone here is great. And this music is incredible. So this record, I'll talk more about it through the night. This record is called Art Pepper Plus 11, recorded in 1960. There are various factors that make this record so incredible. For one thing, it's one of my favorite drummers, Mel Lewis, from the Mel Lewis Thad Jones Orchestra. He's playing on this. Marty Paich is the arranger of all this fantastic music, and his arranging is incredible. It's just so buoyant and joyful and transparent. Feels like a quintet playing instead of 12 people somehow, and yet it's very powerful. And of course, Art Pepper. And tonight, Art Pepper is sort of split up amongst these incredible musicians, Jeff Bradfield, Greg Ward, Rich Moore. And he's this, you know, jazz icon. So we'll talk more about it. That tune was called Move. And we're going to continue with the standard called Groovin' High.
Thank you.
All right, so that was called Opus Defunk. I was mentioning Marty Paich. Let me just talk about him a little bit. So Marty was from California, born in Oakland, and then had his career in California, in L.A. And he was an interesting guy. He was a great pianist and recorded under his own name and as a sideman with a lot of incredible jazz musicians, most notably Mel Torme. So he was Mel Torme's pianist and arranger. They had a band called the Deck Tet, kind of the same size. And then Marty, you know, wrote for his own bands for a long time. And what's interesting to me is that this record is not kind of a one-off. This is actually a band that was recording and working quite a bit. So there are other albums with Art Pepper, with Mel Lewis. There's actually an album with this same band with Scott LaFaro on bass. Dig that. Yeah, I didn't either. Until yesterday. One of the things I love about Marty, and I'm curious if anyone in the band wants to chime in here, this writing to me feels super fresh in that there's like so much content and material, but it feels incredibly light the whole time. It doesn't feel like a big band to me. I love Count Basie, I love Thad Jones. Sometimes that music feels like you're on a bulldozer, kind of just like pushing through time. And this never feels that way to me somehow. It feels like very, very organic and musical. And I think a lot of it, frankly, just has to do with his writing, his arranging. He has a way of orchestrating and scoring things in a really beautiful, transparent way, which I love. Marty went on to do a lot of film scoring. He did some pop records. Linda Ronstadt, he did a Linda Ronstadt record. I've yet to hear that. Matt's a big fan. Linda Ronstadt plus 11, totally, yeah. Didn't sell so well. But yeah, Marty Paich, big part of this record. We're going to continue now with a Monk tune, Thelonious Monk tune. This is Marty's beautiful, beautiful arrangement of Round Midnight. Thank you. All right. How about this band? Yeah. Let me introduce these cats. Jeremy Kahn on piano. Matt Ullery on bass. Up front, we have Jeff Bradfield on tenor. Greg Ward on alto. Rich Moore on alto, tenor, and soon to hear clarinet. And Jacob Slocum playing Barry sax. We have Luke Malevich playing trombone. Andy Baker playing trombone. And Elizabeth Deitemyer playing French horn. And in the back here, we have Chad McCullough playing trumpet. And Quentin Coaxum playing trumpet. Such a pleasure playing with all these incredible musicians. This music is demanding and fun, and they're all killing it. We're gonna actually finish this first set with something super energetic, and then take a short pause, and then we'll finish the record in the second set. This is a really hip tune written by Charlie Parker, arranged, of course, by Marty Paich. This is Sean Nuff. Thank you.
All right, that's Jon Deitemyer, everybody. That is the end of side one. We're going to take a short break and then come back for side two. For those of you in the house, we're going to turn off the lights, hang out, take a look at the artwork. All the work around you is done by the artists within our community, our members. Some of them are here tonight in the room, so feel free to ask them what is going on with them. And then we're going to walk over to John Airo and take a look at his artwork for the set break. And for those of you watching at home, I'm talking to you, Steve Schnall from Dublin, Ohio. Get that wallet out and tip the band. We're all watching what you do. So be generous and kind, tip the band, tip the artist. If you like what you've seen here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective so we can keep doing these performances. All right, we're going to take a short break. Let's give it a moment of time for the band, Jon Deitemyer.
Thank you.
All right, we're back. Welcome to Side 2 with Jon Deitemyer performing Art Pepper's Plus 11. Little known fact about Jon, his nickname is Johnny Green because every show he plays, he guarantees each band member $1,000. So you people at home were only $1,100 short. So dig into those fancy phones. Please be generous and kind. Donate to the band. Tip the artist. If you like what you've seen here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective. All right, we're going to start the show because everybody's in place. Are we all in place? All right, let's give it for Jon Deitemyer. Thank you.
How about Rich Moore on that one? Woo! Yeah, Rich. Feel so fortunate to play with all these cats. This is so great. Let me talk really briefly about Art Pepper. So obviously we talked about Marty Paich and this record on the whole, but Art Pepper is the featured soloist. Art is a really interesting guy. So he is also from California, just like Marty Paich. And he was kind of like a child prodigy. He joined Benny Carter's big band when he was, I think, 18 or 19. And then he switched over to Stan Kenton's orchestra. So he was kind of like the featured soloist in Stan Kenton's band for a long time. And obviously he branched out and did his own projects, worked with small groups, but his sort of entire adult life, he struggled with heroin addiction. He was in and out of prison. And in fact, there are really interesting stories in his biography called Straight Life, which I highly recommend, about just like this weird pendulum swing of his life between incredible creative output and essentially dormant periods where he was in jail or struggling with addiction. And one of the more interesting stories, not necessarily pertaining to this record, but another record called Art Pepper Meets the Rhythm Section. This kind of just, for me, illustrates how sort of crazy some of these cats' lives were. His wife decided that in an attempt to kind of like help him stay clean, she set up a recording session. She kind of like called in some favors, and she set up a recording session. And so she told Art Pepper about this, and he was pissed. He's like, man, I haven't played in a while. My horn's broken. I've been in and out of jail. And this record, in retrospect now, is called Art Pepper Meets the Rhythm Section, where he played with Red Garland and Paul Chambers and Philly Joe Jones. It's incredible. It's this incredible record. And it, essentially, it was done as like a lifeline for Art to stay clean, which is incredible. So I'm certainly not interested in, making a hero of addiction. We all struggle with different things. I think for me, it's just a lesson in how incredibly complex we all are. We can be incredibly creative. We can have really dark periods. We can fight through our own battles. But this music, I think, is just such a testament to joy, to happiness, bringing people together. So I'll choose to focus on that, Art Pepper. That's the beauty. Yeah. So with that in mind, yeah, totally. With that in mind, we're going to follow, we're going to continue with Anthropology. This is a beautiful tune, and this is going to feature Rich on clarinet. This is Anthropology. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here. We've come to the last tune of this record. I can't believe it, but what a pleasure. Once again, Jeff Bradfield, Greg Ward, Rich Moore, Jacob Slocum, Andy Baker, Elizabeth Deitemyer, Luke Malevich, Chad McCullough, Quentin Coaxum, Matt Ullery, Jeremy Kahn. Pleasure playing for you. Thank you so much. And how about John on the visual art over there? Say hello to John. Yeah. And of course, we have to all extend our gratitude to Chris Anderson, who makes these concerts happen at Fulton Street throughout the entire pandemic. And now that we're kind of reopening, Chris has been just like a completely supportive, positive, proactive creator. He's just bringing music to the city. So we owe you a debt of gratitude, Chris. Thank you. Yeah. This last tune we're going to play for you is a classic Charlie Parker tune, and this is called Donna Lee. Hope you enjoy. Thanks for being here.
Jon Deitemyer, everybody. All right. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. The Jazz Record Art Collective is back here on Thursday night, where Fareed Haq will be performing Pat Martino's 1977 release, Joyous Lake, so please come back for that. As far as our regular programming, if you're playing here tomorrow night, raise your hand. Jacob Slocum's The Low End, a baritone saxophone night. Seven berries? Yeah, boy, that sounds like a good number. Seven berries, or nine, ten. So please come back for that. If you're watching from home, it's time to be generous and kind. Please donate to the band. Please donate to the artist. If you like what you see in here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective. For you in the house, we're going to turn up the lights. From here on out, all the money goes to the band. So the fishbowl is over there. The online stuff is over there. So hang out, be cool, grab a glass of wine, look at the artwork. This is very much a collaborative effort. We have Dan Tekler on sound tonight. Harvey Tillis, still photography. And a video, Jose Valle. Again, thank you so much for joining us tonight. We're back here tomorrow night. Until then, get vaccinated. We'll see you then.
I was here for it.
Be back tomorrow night.
Yep. That'll
be fun.
No, that's gonna be fun.
I expect my entire body to be vibrating. You know, but this was just so wonderful. And I have people like never change it. Yeah, no one's killing me. It's interesting from a visual point of view. I see how different musicians hold their instruments. But on piano, plays especially. I could almost pick out his sound from Greg's sound, almost. Getting good at picking drummers out, so. But I need a lot of practice with that. Come on, man. I'll see you around.